research is monumentous because medical practices of the past have developed into fresh alternative ideas of the future. I've been studying biomedical sciences for 4 years now, and I feel this is a very good topic, and I've always been intrigued by it. The topic of growing organs has been affected by the past, the present, and what we intend for the future. First of all, the past is so important and is where we started to form our ideas and helps us learn what we need to do better. It is actually very hard to find a match for an organ. So they start out with cross matching, that's where they do the blood typing and the Rh type, and then they see if those match. And then they do a recipient antibody screening, and then sometimes even after that, something can happen and it doesn't work out. So the idea of all this started out with skin grafting, and that is where they take a good part of your skin and grow it in a petri dish and put it on the infected area. So Harvard's research is where they plan to do a normal organ transplant and then harvest your stem cells, and then take that patch of stem cells that they grow in a petri dish like skin grafting and put it on your organ, and then eventually that will take over all of your organ and you have no risk of rejection anymore. So from Johns Hopkins Medicine, they have the paired exchange, aka the kidney swap, and that is where you have a willing donor, but they don't match at all. So then they get a whole group of people together and they make sure everybody has the person that can donate to them. Although we need the past to get to where we are today, the present is where we need to be. So a 3D printer, well, this is a picture of one, and from 3Dprinting.com, a 3D printer is where they have, it's computer control, and they put whatever material they need in it, in our case, stem cells, and that where it gets put in, moves back and forth, and it creates the image that you wanted. So far they have grown a beating heart on the 3D printer, and they hooked it up to a bypass machine and it worked for about 30 minutes. The present is a good building block, however the future is where we grow. So there's four different types of stem cells. The first one is the embryonic, and they give rise to every type of cell in the fully formed body except the placenta and the umbilical cord. So tissue-specific stem cells generate different cell types with a specific tissue or organ, and the mesenchymal stem cells are located from the stroma, the connective tissue that surrounds other tissues and organs. And another type is a endosporid platelet, and they are engineered in lab by converting tissue-specific cells, such as skin cells, into cells that behave like embryonic stem cells. And the one that most likely used for 3D printing would be these tissue-specific cells. So there's many plans for stem cell research. They plan to cure Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, diabetes, and many other diseases with this. But there's also going to be side effects. And one of the side effects will be obviously from general anesthesia because you're getting an organ transplant. And those side effects include nausea, vomiting, dry mouth, and sore throat. And then you will have also side effects from stem cell transplant. And that is risk of infection, low red blood cell count, risk of bleeding, graft versus host disease, and a long-term side effect can be infertility. Overall, stem cell research is monumentous because medical practices of the past have developed into fresh alternative ideas of the future. It is important to be informed. The future of medicine and growing organs will save lives. One ethical concern with growing organs from stem cells is that people believe that you're playing God. God molded us with his very own hands from each organ to toe he made us. And they believe it is not okay for us to make organs like God. Another ethical concern is that the embryonic stem cells would not be able to be humans anymore, thus believing that this has led to mass murder. Lastly, another concern is that if it doesn't work, you're still going to die and you put all of your hope into this one very thing working. Ultimately, in every new idea or invention, there's always going to be someone that's going to pick apart your new innovation and develop concerns. Therefore, I hope that once this gets approved, you consider being a part of this pivotal invention in medicine.